Is it going? Oh snap, it's going. All right, sweet. Sweet. Okay, I gotta do a couple of things before we get really started. Yep. Nice, nice. What's up, Freemason? It is Lenscap indeed. A wild Lenscap, even. How's it going, pal? Alright, I'm just trying to get some things set up before we get started. I'm a little bit early. So I'm looking for, a few things on my end. I'm doing all right. I'm doing all right. Not bad this morning. Not bad this morning at all. We're going to be working on the freighter. Keyframe frequency. Okay, I'm getting some error messages, so I wanted to start a little bit early so I could fix these things. If I disappear for a second, I'll be right back, I promise. I'm just trying to fix some settings before we get really started into this. Yeah, nice. Okay. Encoder settings. Okay. All right, it'll be fine. Let's do it. Let's get into it. So we're gonna work on a thing today, a magical thing. We're gonna work on the freighter. We're gonna start building the freighter for the solar sailor kind of thing that we've been working on. So this will be a lot of fun. Thank you. I should share this on Twitter, probably. Let's see. There we go. That'd be cool. All right. All right. All right. Creative mode. Where are we at? So do you want to, let's check this out first, guys. This is in the last episode of StarMade I made. We did that forklift thing. Put a little bit of a shell on it. This is what I came up with. It's okay. It's okay. It could be better for sure. But this is what we got for now. I tried to put some fins on it, like the sails and stuff, but it just didn't work at all, because of the size constraints. So I ended up doing like this orange fin on the bottom, which worked out okay. It tends to look all right. So, yeah, I mean, it's not bad. It's not bad. There are some parts showing. I wish I could have hidden the parts a little better. Those buttons specifically, but yeah, I mean, what can you do? You know, you can't win them all, so it doesn't look bad, though. Cool. We can hop in and take a peek to extend the arms and stuff. Let's see, I need the, so here's the view from the camera, and it's pretty quick. So, but if we toggle the arms, I really like how the arms came out, but I ended up doing like scaffolding and stuff, on them. So I feel like it suits the style, the build style of the rest of the fleet too. So that's pretty sweet. And then of course, all the functionality is the same. I didn't change any of the insides. Oh, I got these new pipe blocks. I put some pipe blocks on it, so that's cool. I'm not sure how to use the new pipe blocks yet because they don't really, like I like to do, use slabs to cover the buttons. That's a good idea, but I can't because that's where these green pickup rails are. So I can't put anything there. Because the rails are invisible when you're in, like, when you're looking at it outside of build mode. Slabs is a good idea, but unfortunately in this case it's not possible because there are blocks there, they're just invisible blocks. The pipes, I wish they came in different colors. If I could get different colored pipes, I would probably use them a lot more. As it stands, I might use them a little bit, but I'm a big fan of being able to, of the paint cans for pipes. Okay, so anyway, that's that thing, and it works. It's okay. It's cool. It's cool. We're gonna integrate one into our freighter. Hopefully at least one. So I got a couple of things that I want for this freighter, and I'm glad we're getting to do this on a live stream, honestly, because I had some questions that I wanted some input for some guys, from you guys before I really got into it. There are a couple of things that I wasn't quite sure about before I got started. I wanted to know, like, what do you guys think, how many people crew a freighter? Like, how many people do I need in the bridge? Like, how many does it take to, how many licks does it take to get the center of a freighting spaceship or something? I'm thinking 3 to 5, maybe? We don't want to do hot bunking, though. Like, so hot bunking, if you don't know, is when you make your crew share beds. So like sleep in shifts kind of thing, and that's not cool. So we want to have enough beds for everybody, but we want to make sure that the ship can run around the clock, right? So that way, that means is if there are three stations, like three like operator stations, then we need 6 beds, right? So you can do one shift on, one shift off. I'm thinking probably about that size, maybe. I don't know. What do you guys think? We can go ahead and get started, though. building it. We gotta start the core, so I'm not gonna name this until we get a little bit more stuff in it. Let's hit C. All right, so what do we need? We're gonna need gray. We're gonna need dark gray. I want red standard. To get started, let's see. We're just doing, so we're gonna start with like a, let's give ourselves a little bit more room too. So a lot of people start their ships, captain, comms operator, and a pilot. So three. That's kind of what I was thinking too. And then maybe like one other person as well to work the actual freight part of it, right? Oh, hey, Robin Shield, welcome to the stream. Okay, so yeah, I'm thinking you're good though, Freemason. I think that's a good thought. Three guys maybe in the cockpit and a fourth guy that works freight. So we need we'll need eight beds, or I guess we'll just need seven because the captain doesn't necessarily. We don't need two captains. So what about crew to operate turrets and so on? Yeah, that's a good point too. I figured the turrets are controlled by AI, so maybe don't necessarily need crew for turrets, but we could do a European convenience stream. Yeah, man, well, it's my day off for my real job, so I wanted to get started early. crew to operate turrets and so on. So it's a freighter, right? It's going to have a couple of turrets, but the ship isn't necessarily designed for combat. It's more for just hauling goods back and forth. How many? Here's my next question for you guys, though. So I think we're going to do a crew. Let's just call it eight. Let's call it eight and a captain, and I think that'll cover all of our needs. And then we can have four people working at any given time. But what do you guys think about cargo pods? Like, how big should it be? How many pods should we have? I haven't really put a lot of thought into this at all, so I'm still just kind of waiting on ideas. I wanted input before I really got started. Let's set some symmetry for this first bit. So I was thinking six pods, maybe. And need engineers for reactors and so on. A ship could use a lot of people. Yeah, that's true. That's true. You could use a lot of people on a ship. Depending on the size of the ship, though, right? Like a smaller ship, you can wear multiple hats. You know, so like your comms guy could also monitor power systems and whatnot. You need at least 12 for 8-hour shifts. Yeah. Gosh, this ship is just getting bigger and bigger, isn't it? That's cool. That's cool. We need a big ship. In our fleet. And I think a freighter is a good place to have a big ship, especially like, so the idea behind these guys, right, they're pirates, kind of. They're like scavenger pirate kind of dudes. And like the lore or whatever, if we're going to do a lore kind of thing of it. And so pirates, if you think about like pirates traditionally, of course they're aggressive and heavily armed, but at the same time, like, they're really just traders. Traders, not the other kind, and with guns, and then they kind of ransack and whatnot. So we almost need like a really good freighter, and then we can slap guns on it. How much cargo you want to drag around at once is the question. Once you know that, you'll know how many pods you need. Yeah, that's true. That's true. Honestly, so far on the server, like, we don't have. I've seen a lot of variance in kind of that idea. Like, so I generally run one pod is a lot of cargo. Honestly, these pods are huge. They're so huge. They're so much bigger than you expect they are, and they hold so much more cargo than you expect them to. But I was thinking maybe three pods, maybe. So I'm kind of torn. On how many pods I want. I was thinking maybe three pods, but that seems kind of low. Like Garth has eight, and Sven has eight, and I think Tops holds eight. And that's a lot of cargo, though, guys. Like, that's just crazy. Didn't know I did live stream. Yeah, I don't really. This is only the second one I've ever done. So, so there's that. I'd like to do it more though. If this is cool, if people are into this, I would do this more. I'm having fun, and I'll do live streaming often when I get chance. When I get a chance. All right, so we're doing a bridge first. I start my ships. I kind of work from the front back, and I almost do my ships backwards from everybody else I've ever watched build in StarMade. Most people build the outside and then they build the inside, but I don't want to do that. I start on the inside and work my way out, which is kind of, yeah, backwards. Lucky us. Whatever, guys. Yeah, I guess. I'm not that special, but thanks. Okay, so cockpit. We're kind of doing something similar to this one, but I don't want to copy it exactly. But I really like the idea. Maybe we invert it. Yeah, let's do that. Let's invert it. Okay, this is a cool idea. We want. Let's see. Let's give it one more. Whoops. Let's do this. So that's where El Capitan sits. Well, make it big now because as you grow as players, your cargo space will have to be bigger. Yeah, that's true. That's true. So I'm thinking 8 pods is way excessive. I'm thinking half that many is plenty of cargo. Like I currently, if I take everything I own on the Star Squadron server, I can fit it in one pod. So I'm thinking 4 pods is probably enough. And if we do 4 pod slots, then that lets me have either 4 pods or 3 pods and a forklift. And I definitely want the forklift on the ship. So. I'm thinking we might do that. Okay, Tolerath says, one of the ships I'm most proud of, I built the interior first, then built a huge box around that, and then built the exterior around that. Then I built systems into that space. Yeah, that's kind of my strategy as well. That's very similar to my strategy as well. Like this ship is kind of how I did that. I started with the bridge because you got to place the core first, and I got to know like give me proportions, man. I don't know proportions until I put them in. So I built the bridge first, and then I was like, okay, coming off the bridge, I need a hallway, and then I need some rooms. So I put the rooms, and then I was like, okay, now I need rooms for systems. So I built this, and then I put a shell on the front, and then I built. Then I was like, I need more systems, so I built this thing, and then I put the shell on, and then I put the engines. So that's kind of the order I went in when I did that. Yeah, I'm with you though, man. I gotta build the inside first. I gotta have a sense of proportion, otherwise I have no idea what's going on. Like, I don't know how big to make the outside if I don't have the inside yet. How big is one pod? I built one to your specifications to test it. It was only around 70K for me, which is still pretty big. Yes, no, that's about right. That's about right. 70K is about right. I've got this one over here, which holds 84, no, it holds 73K, and this is like the max a pod can hold. And then if you put a little bit, 17 by 9 by 9, yeah, that's right. But they hold about 80K if you fill it all the way full of cargo spaces, but mine are a little bit smaller because I have the beveled edges. So, but about 70K sounds right. But I'm thinking. Yeah, I'm thinking 3 to 4 pods. I don't know. We'll cross that bridge when we get to it. It's all about proportion, right? It's all about proportion. So we got to know how big is the bridge first. That's kind of step number one. All right, so the captain is gonna sit there. Let's give him a little bit of room behind him. I think we'll probably do something cool like we did in this ship with the hologram map thing. We might work into some more details too, but the hologram map thing, I think that was a cool touch. It looks better with the edges like yours. Oh, thank you. Yeah, like the container style versus the, or like the, like, what am I trying to say? Like the almost the drum, like a cargo drum versus a like a shipping container. Which shipping containers in real life are rectangular because it's more it's easier to build them and more cost effective to build something simple like that. I like the slab stairs, so I think we're gonna do slab stairs. Maybe halves? No, we can go even better than that. We could do this. Yep. That's what we're doing. So we need stairs here. We're gonna do it kind of like the way the other let's see, what do we want? Like this. Kind of way the other bridges, that one, but inverted. So the shape you use is a capsule. Yeah, that's true. That's true. That's a good word for it. Excuse me. So kind of like the way the other bridge is, but inverted. Let's see, how's that? Aha, okay, so we're gonna have to do it actually this. And building in StarMade is not exactly the most exciting thing to watch in the world, in my opinion. But I figured it was a pretty good format for a live stream because we can kind of play ideas off of each other and stuff this way. How long do you want to stream? A couple of hours, probably. It's 10 o'clock my time. I figure if I stream till 1 o'clock, I don't know. It depends on how much we get accomplished. But yeah, probably a couple of hours. I got no plans for today other than this, so I figure we'll do it for as long as I can. I might do, let's see, instead of these, if we do the stairs upside down like this, it kind of is a little bit more, what? It suits the tone, I guess, better if we come from any other directions. Okay, but this has to be tall enough for someone to fit under, so we need at least a few more stairs. This is getting big fast. We may have to move these stairs back. Okay, man. I will see you I'll see you later. I'll swing by later on. Thanks for stopping in. Yeah, well, let's move these back a couple blocks. So we're gonna do this. Is that four? So there's one block, two blocks, it's three blocks. Was this like six? Seven? Three wide, whatever. Copy this area. Oh, dang it. Dang it. We gotta do some more blocks. Oh no, we could do it from this side. Okay, yes. No, maybe. What is going on? I don't know how this works. I forgot how to play this game. Lenscap, why don't you do the stairs ASIM? You know what? That's a great idea. I'm doing that. Good call. Good call, my friend. I love the ASIM stuff. I kind of want the captain's chair in the middle, but we definitely can do ASIM stairs. And then we can make them a little bit more narrow, too, that way. If we're only going to have a crew of a couple of people at once, then we don't need big wide stairs like that. That's a good thought. I'm putting together a light slash heat sensor Arduino for my class, so I'm just kind of keeping you in the background. Okay, cool, man. Yeah, hopefully I can be entertaining and while you're doing that. That sounds like a really cool project. That's a great thing to work on today. Okay, so we can put, that's a good idea. The ASIM stairs is a great idea because we can put like our nav computer thing over here, like this, the map thing. Yes, good call, good call. All right, so we'll do that. And you know how much I love my asymmetry, so yes, perfect. Thank you for the idea. That's a great idea. We'll figure it out, we'll figure it out. We don't even need wedges yet, we're not there yet. All right, so let's come out two blocks then and do our stairs. I wish there was an easier way to do this, but I don't know of one without like copy paste. I don't mind that much though. I'm not like super efficient builder guy, so. All right. This month is the most fun I've had doing these things. I never planned to do game developer. Okay. They got you doing Mayo and Arduinos. Yeah, I went to college actually for the school I went to called the major I had what was it? It was a game development major. Basically we did computer graphics and stuff like that for games and movies. I mean, you could go on and do film, but the emphasis was on gaming. And that was cool. Digital art and design. And so that was a really interesting major. We used a lot of Maya and stuff like that too. So I know exactly what you're getting into. That's a really fun thing. Now, I wasn't very good at it, so I'm better at playing games and making them, turns out. All right, what? Let's see. What do we want to do down here then? If we're gonna do ASIM stairs, that kind of opens this up for a little bit more room down here underneath. Let's see. Let's do. How tall is this? We need at least. I want 3 blocks because I want these guys to have some headroom. Yeah, so that'll work. So here's our floor. That's cool. And then how big do we need to make this area? Hmm. 95% programming. Yeah, I played this game. I got this phone game yesterday that I've been playing on my phone called Human Resource Machine. And it's kind of programmy. It feels very programmy. If you've ever heard of it, you could have a side window on the opposite side of the stairs. Yeah, that's a good point. I was thinking a window. I'm not sure what shape the bridge is going to be, but I think we're going to do probably, I mean, it's going to be similar to the other ships, you know, it's fleet kind of thing. So they all need to be at least a little bit similar. What color do I have the floor in here? Is this gray? Oh, is this gray or is this dark gray? This is dark gray, isn't it? Okay, we may have to change this and this ship too then. But we can build in gray for now and do the remove. What was I saying? Human resource man robot manager. What was it called? Machine. Human resource machine. Yeah, it's a pretty cool game. It's very programmer. You have like the first mission is like, hey, take these things from the inbox and put them in the outbox. And you have to write a little program that loops basically that says get from inbox, print to outbox, and then you loop back to the start. And then the like programs and the tasks get more complicated as you go from there. It's a very interesting game. It's a very interesting game. Yeah, I got stumped on one of the levels, so I'm kind of thinking about that in the background. I find a lot of the times if I get stuck on a problem like that, I just give it a couple days and the answer will come to me, so no worries. So we've got our captain or pilot. Oh, you know what we can do? What are those new console? That's what they're called. We can throw some of these in. I wish there were different colors of the consoles too, though. You know, they're all the same. I wish there was like a red one and a blue one. I'm sure they'll come out with that kind of stuff. Learned about threading. Okay. That's something I don't know about. Okay, so let's have 2 stations down here. You said, hold on, let me go back in the chat. We suggested comms officer. Let's see. Oh, I gotta go back kind of far. Captain, comms officer, weapons operator, and a pilot. Neat block, but needs some variations. Yeah, I agree. I agree. And the pipes as well. I already mentioned the pipes, but yeah, I wish they had colored pipes. That'd be better. But it's cool. I like where they're going with it. And I mean, this is the kind of thing that I'm glad they're adding, and I hope they touch on it again instead of just kind of like, yeah, we did something, let's move on to the next thing. Like, I hope they kind of refine it a little bit. StarMade has a tendency to do both. So, sometimes they add stuff and just kind of like, yeah, it's in, let's move on to the next thing. And they don't really ever polish it or finish it up. And then sometimes they'll actually polish stuff and finish it up. So I don't know where they're going to go with these things. Threading is, let's say you have an 8-core processor. I have a huge bulky program. I'm trying to run one on it. Without threading, I can run my program on one of your 8 cores. Oh, I gotcha. So threading lets you use multiple cores of my processor, which makes your program run more efficiently, right? Am I right? Am I close? I think that's close. That would make sense. Okay, so we need comms and weapons. I guess we use the consoles. Let's see. Should we make all the officers have different colored chairs? Oh, we need some lights too. What color lights? White? And, oh, you know what? We need to do the red alert kind of thing like we have in the other ship too. So we need white and red. I don't guess we have to do that, but I thought it was a pretty cool effect. Yeah, if I have 8 threads running, I can use all 8 cores. Okay. AMD 8-core thread is good, but it's not quite Intel. Yeah, for sure. I've got all AMD parts in my computer, and I don't know, man. Like even my graphics card is an AMD card, and it's not bad. I got no complaints really, but I feel like the Nvidia cards are better for gaming and whatnot. Now I think we generally tended to use at when I was in school, we used the AMD cards for like video rendering and stuff, and that seemed to work out okay. But I don't know if an Nvidia card would be better for that. I haven't really looked into it too much. Okay, I'm not liking this. I'm not liking this. I need some more ideas. I need some more structure around this. So let's start with, okay, what are we gonna build this out of? So it's a freighter, but we're pirates, so we kind of want it to be. Threading is underused. It's hard to use safely. Oh, I missed a comment. The downside is if two threads ever try and mess with the same data at the same time, everything breaks. Okay. Yeah, do you like that 780? That was the next card I was thinking about getting once I get a new car. But I just bought this card last year, so. So it'll probably be a while before I get another card. Let's do dark gray advanced armor. Since we are kind of piratical, right? We want to have some armor. We also want our orange crystal for windows. Okay, let's see. So shape of this. Okay, so we want this to extend a couple of blocks away. Oh my gosh, I'm moving blocks all over the place. So let's come out like 5 or 6 blocks. That's probably good. And then throw one of these here. We can kind of make a ring. The outside can be a little bit symmetric. All right, so see what I'm saying? Like I jump around a lot. So we barely have an inside going, and I'm already starting on the outside. Okay, I'm thinking like this kind of shape for underneath. Yeah, that's cool. That'll work. That'd be good. It's not VR ready. Okay. Yeah, the VR thing is really cool. That's something I'd like to check out at some point, but I'm just not there yet. I'm still iffy about it. So I don't know when I'll be ready to do that kind of thing, but I think that looks like a really cool thing, and that's definitely the next, like the next place that gaming is gonna go, I think. Virtual reality for sure. All right, so how big? This bridge isn't going to be super huge because it's only, we're only going to have like four or so people running at once. So let's see. Yeah, that's a pretty good size. That's a pretty good size. Let's get rid of those. And we're going to need a little bit more structure on this. So we're going to come. Let's do it here. That gives us three in the middle. Yeah, that'd be good. Okay, and then these will come down like so far. Who knows? This will come up maybe two blocks, and then we'll do wedges back. So I'm trying to get this kind of shape. Because this is the shape that we have on all of the ships. They all have the same kind of shaped cockpit. So that's the shape we're going for. A move core tool. Yeah, for sure, for sure. Then I wouldn't have to start in the stupid core room every time. Okay, now I like the way that this happened actually on this ship a little better, where it has the big window in the front so you can see really well. But we could accomplish that by simply removing those blocks. But it is kind of more industrial feeling because it's a freighter, so maybe it needs more like structural support on the bridge, kind of cockpit bridge area. Like that, maybe. Maybe one more. So this is where we decide this is really this first external bit that we're doing. This is really where we decide how big the ship is, ultimately. Yeah, that's pretty good. We want to make sure there's plenty of space in the bridge, but we don't want it to be too big. And then this will probably come down to about here. And you know what? I just had a cool idea. Okay, we're gonna. This is a cool idea. I'm thinking this bridge maybe, because I was gonna just put it on the front of the ship, like this. But I'm thinking maybe the ship is further underneath it. It's further back on the ship, and off to one side. So maybe like the center of mass of the ship is actually here. That'd be kind of cool. Is this ship gonna be. Oh, some guy, welcome to the stream. Okay, is this ship gonna be bigger than the rest? If so, you could extend the body down a little under the cockpit to make like a big sloping J shape. Yeah, that's a good idea. Okay, Tallarth, you're way over my head, but I'm glad you're talking about it. I'm learning from you, and I like to learn new things. Let's remove that. Okay. How are we gonna do this? How are we gonna do this? So we almost want these. Nah, it's cool. This is cool. This is good. This is good. Let's see. So let's go ahead and start putting some of this crystal armor in. Let's actually put a support here, and we'll call that the bottom of the window. And I don't know what's going to go down below the window yet, but we'll cross that bridge when we get to it, man. No sense rushing. We got all day. We got all day. No X. Boop, boop, boop. Like this. Yeah, how big does this window actually need to be above us? Pretty big, right? We want to be able to see pretty far. That's probably good. All right, and then we can pull this structure back too. Like an aircraft carrier? Maybe not. Yeah, well, yeah, shaped like an aircraft carrier, yeah. Not big like one. We're definitely not doing kind of drones or anything. Although, drones could be cool. Let's pull this out at least one past this. Freemason, have you seen my series on Interstellar Rift yet? It sounds similar to what you're describing, I think, if I'm understanding what you're saying correctly. The way they do their ships. That seems like that's a really fun game, guys. Like a helm block? You could have stealth drones that look the same as your containers. Yeah, man. Yes. Yes, that's a great idea. And that sounds exactly like the kind of thing that that an unscrupulous pirate such as myself would do. Okay, I decided that I want these to be kind of tucked in a little bit, depth and whatnot. So let's go ahead and make that a thing. And we can almost. Let's see. How do we want to do this, though? How do we want to accomplish it? Yeah, I think it'd be fine like that. Like that. Interstellar Rift has a cockpit, yeah. It's a pretty fun game. It's pretty fun. I'm not sure where it's gonna go though, like how in depth it actually is gonna be yet. I'm having fun with it though. Like the missions they have are cool. I can't wait for StarMade to start adding that kind of stuff. I know they're planning on doing that, so I'm interested to see when they start adding that. I can't wait for this fleet competition to be over, honestly, because then we'll get a bunch of cool stuff. You know, I'm waiting for AI and things like that really. That's gonna be awesome. And then this is gonna need to be, what, one of these maybe? No. I don't know yet. I don't know yet. I don't know yet. Okay, and we gotta start our curve somewhere, so that looks like a good spot to start it. And how about we do. Let's stick some wedges in here. Some more wedges. Let's do this. Yeah, and then this. That. Yep, that's what we want. Like that. How's that? Looks all right. Looks just fine. Looks like it needs a support bar between the two bars and the front of the helm. Are you talking about? Yeah, I don't know how StarMade determines that kind of stuff on the back end. I don't know. Okay. Let's check out some more window action. Oh. Oh. Yes. Is that good? That's good. That looks good. Yeah. Yes. And then it needs something else. Ah, you know what? Perhaps we do. This is just a test, you know. I'm flying by the seat of my pants here, so I have no idea really what I'm doing until I do it. So, are we gonna like this? If we get rid of, whoops. What in the world is going on? I don't know how to play this game anymore. If we get rid of that, this will make it feel more sturdy, but we don't want to remove all of the windows. You know, we want these guys to be able to see out, but they're not flying the ship, so it's not as crucial for them to be able to see what's going on. You fixed it with the sidebars, dude. Okay, thanks. I'm on the same page, man. We got this. You and I, we're together on this one. We're a team. We got this. All right, let's, so how do we feel about this? How do we feel about this? How do we feel about this? It needs, no, we could do windows like here. Small ones, maybe. Did I really leave that there? That's, oh, I needed that one. Whoops, this. Do we need little windows there? Yeah, for sure we do. Can we make it happen though? Is that kind of weird? How's that feel? Feels kind of weird, I don't know. The bottom floor windows could be sunk, could be like network basement windows sunk into the main hull. Okay, I see what you're saying. Yeah, like the top of the hull is like on this level kind of, and maybe comes out around kind of like that, and then, okay. Yeah, I like that. That's a great idea. Let's do gray instead of crystal to mark our spot. I like that. Okay, like sunken in basement windows. Yeah, that's a good call. That's a good idea. These windows you're talking about? Yeah, I like, I'm on the fence, but I think it's cool. I think it's cool. It needed something there. Like it was just too flat. So without them. All right, so what do we need next? These? We're gonna start on trying to get the curve right now. So there. Okay, and so that makes this, oop, here, like this. Definitely there, and definitely there. Oh, Okay, well, we'll get there. Don't get ahead of yourself. Like that. This. We're gonna have to use triangles, aren't we? Triangle? No, we're not, because we're gonna do this. There we go. So that'll fix that, and then we can use one of these. Yes. Fantastic. That's perfect. That's beautiful. Okay, and this block needs to be one of these fellas. And so does this block. And that can be there. Boom. Got our curve on our window. That was easy. You know what adds depth? Lighting. Ship without depth would be like a sandwich without bread. Yeah, you guys are right. You guys are for sure right. But this is looking pretty good. It's looking pretty good so far. We don't have much, but but what we have is I'm liking it. All right, so this next bit, how do we want to do the windows here? I'm thinking we need another piece of structure here-ish. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, yeah, odd numbers, so that'll work. like that, and that, and that, and that, and that's too far, like that. How's that look from far away? Yeah, and then this maybe doesn't even need to be this long. It can be 3. And then we can kind of figure out what to do with the back part of this. Yeah, so there we go. Now we know the ends. And maybe this window, I don't know. Okay, so that means we can get rid of these blocks. We don't want extra blocks, you know, if we can avoid it. We want to save on materials, because I am going to have to build this thing eventually in survival. Yeah. Did you know gluten in bread is actually good for you? Yeah, I did know that. All this gluten-free garbage that people are spewing about. Anyway, I'm not going to talk about that. I don't like to talk about controversial stuff, but... Gluten is good for you in, you know, everything in moderation, right? This is 3. That looks pretty good. How could we make it better? How could we make it better? Let's look at it from far away. I don't know. That looks pretty good. How could we make it better? How could we make it better? It's too much glass. It's too much glass. We need more hull. So let's get rid of these windows. Maybe not all the way. How do we like this? Yeah. Yes. Yes. Okay, yes. I like it. I like it. I like it. And then how does this kind of angle work? Because this is going to be on top of the ship, and where does the armor, how does the armor relate? Some people are allergic to glutens, but very few people, actually. I know a couple of people with celiac disease. That's the disease where you're allergic to gluten. Yeah, there aren't a lot of people that actually have that. A lot of people just are, like, on health kicks. Dude, I see the weirdest stuff when I go to the grocery store. Okay, I guess we are talking about this. I see, like, gluten-free, like, beans and stuff, like, or, like, gluten-free... I don't know, like gluten-free vegetables? Yeah, of course they're gluten-free. That nut vegetables don't have that in them, generally. So I don't understand it. I don't understand. It's more of a buzzword than an actual like health thing. And that's what bothers me about the gluten-free stuff. You know, it's like sugar-free and fat-free. Like, some fats are good for you, man. You gotta have that kind of stuff in your diet. It's all about balance and stuff when you're talking about diets. Okay, now this is ultimately not gonna be gray hull, but I wanted to go ahead and work out the shape, I think. Like this, and then this, and then okay, this, No, this. I'm just kind of eyeballing this. I have no idea what I actually want this to look like. So, okay, this. How's that? Is that weird? That's kind of weird. Can we replace this with a triangle? Yes. I love the triangle blocks. They're so useful. Gluten-free condoms. Gluten-free gluten? Yeah, for real. Gluten-free vegetables. It's the weirdest thing ever. Okay, this. And again. And then this. Boom. There we go. So that's our hull. So that kind of fits in. Okay. I'm getting it. I'm getting it. I'm getting it. So this is gonna. So now how do we fill in the gaps? So this will be here, like this. And then we need. That can just be a block. We'll need something. I want, like, maybe this? Yeah, I don't know. Then I have a really hard edge. Okay, we can do that there. This will probably be replaced with brown, maybe, because it's the armor. We gotta get the shape first. Can we do this here? Is that gonna be weird? Yeah, we almost need a full block. And then, God, that's gonna have to be a full block too. Yeah, I don't know about this. I may have to revisit this later when I have a. Okay, Mason, see you later. See you later. From the middle of the front window, make a line so you know how long abouts. Do you mean like toward the front of the ship or toward the back of the ship? How can we? Yeah, this is a really weird shape. I don't like this at all. Let's get rid of these. It needs to be much more simple than that. So let's just do it with cubes and then we can figure it out from there. So once I want it to be here. Yeah, like that. Like a collar, kind of. And then I'm thinking it'll go. We want these windows to be functional, but not too functional. X, Y, and Z will help you picture it. Yeah, but I don't know what I want, what kind of shape I want the ship to be yet, even, so I'm not ready to do that yet. I'll get there, I'll get there. Okay, so. This. That's pretty good. Can we remove some of these blocks so I get a better idea of this? It's kind of curved like this, and then up and over. Yep. Okay, so that's where our armor's gonna go. And then I guess these will be like this. What else could we do? What else could we do? Okay, we can figure out the curve of the armor next, I guess. Oh, you know what would work? Is, no, don't reboot. If we just drop this straight down, And then we could do, oh, we could do some like crazy mood lighting or something. Okay, how, let's see, what else did I take away? That one. And we could put like lights like this that you don't see. Let's use parsing. Or let's use a different color. Let's use orange. The colored lights are kind of hit or miss in my opinion. Like a lot of people like to use the various colored lights, and I'm like for lighting and interiors and stuff, and I'm not a big fan of that. How do we feel about the colored lights? What's the block Lenscap has in hotkey 4? This is the console. It looks like this. It is a new block. It's one of the new things they've added. Yeah, that's it. It's the console. It doesn't actually do anything. It's just decorative, for now. I don't know if they intend to make it do anything. Yeah, it's a new decorative block. Pretty small. There's another one they added as well. They called it a pipe. So let's place a couple of those just to look at them. So that's the new pipes, and I'm waiting for colored pipes before I really start using them too much. But that's the pipes as well. So that's the other new block. The point of these blocks, they are, oh gosh, I can't remember the term, but they're the idea is that the farther away you get from them, see how once we cross this certain threshold, they switch into cubes? And the pipes do it too. The pipes looks like they switch to like paint cans. But they switch farther away. That's to help with your processor. So you're not trying to render so many shapes at once. It just makes it a cube if you get farther away. But if you're close to it, then it looks like a console. And yeah, it's supposed to make your ship a little bit easier. Colored light is good for ambiance. Yeah, it is. It is. But people like way overdo it, and only certain colors really work, I feel like. Like you don't wanna like who's gonna have a room that has like crazy, whoops, I took a screenshot. Like green lights. Who's gonna have a room that has only green lights in it? You know, like that's weird, and I people do that sometimes, and I don't know. I mean, it works. It works. If you can make it work, you can make it work, and that's awesome. I just could never find a way to make it work. So you don't have to like everything that everyone does. Do we need to clean this up on the inside? Maybe eventually, maybe not now. Maybe we don't need to clean it up. Who knows? Who cares? I don't really care. There, that's close enough. Oh wait. That's backwards. I'd have to do it on this side. I should be using that trick that that Jace Machine showed in his video, in his recent video, where you do it out of like pink hull or something and then replace it with glass. That was a good one. Maybe a colorblind builder uses lots of lights. Yeah, maybe. I can imagine engines growing green. So yeah, I'm with you. Like the engines could grow gle could grow could glow green and put off like a glow that lights the room. That way, but yeah, I don't know though. Like a regular room, though, it just doesn't work. I don't think it works. All right, let's get back to this shape a little bit. When I build, and as you guys can see, like I'm all over the place. This is how I build though. I work on like six different things at once, and I'll get stumped and then move on to the next thing, and then get stumped and then move on somewhere else and come back later, and that's how I gotta do it. Okay, so we could do, let's see, if we do triangle blocks. Yeah. Yeah, that works. And then we can do these. Okay, that works. That works. That works just fine. Like that. Triangle blocks again. This and this. How's she looking? She looking good. All right, so we need to. Maybe I should have done this out of brown already. We know it's gonna be brown. Let's go ahead and switch it. Let's grab our brown advanced, and we're gonna do remove replace. Let's look at what we want. Replace with active slot selected. Looking at. Okay, am I not looking at the right thing? There we go. Oh, because I have. Okay. Oh, I can't make it work because I'm. Okay, there we go. Where else have we got some that are visible? Is that it? That's pretty much it. The rest are like wedges and stuff. Yes. Yes. I'm not sure about these orange things in the corners. Let's use lava. I like lava. Lava, I guess. Lava? I don't know. I always say lava. Why brown the outer collar might look better in a lighter color. Yeah, but it's the fleet thing. It's the fleet thing. Because the rest of the fleets are brown. It's the armor plating, so. This will need some funky difference things. Okay, next we want to do. We'll do. You know, it might be easier to just do it like this. The other blocks. Less efficient? Probably. Easier? Probably. I'm all about easy. Can you guys hear my birds in the background? I've got some birds. Whenever I'm editing my videos, I can always hear them in the background's cheeping. And gosh, they're so loud. I've got a couple of pets actually. It's like a mini zoo in my house. I have Oh, Dugamus, welcome Dugamus. I have an idea. Add chin-mounted guns on this ship using capsules. Okay, this is a cool idea, John, and I'm glad you said that. Also, hold on, let me back up a second. Creating the Reaper. Welcome to my stream, first of all. Second of all, it's a freighter. We're working on the freighter for the sailing kind of style. Okay, so you can flick the light switch and go into a dimly lit machinery look. I missed something. Other neat uses for lights would be having ambient light in various colors everywhere, but having toggleable white lights as your main light source. Okay, I do something similar in let me hop out of this core. I do something similar in this ship, where I've got a button that toggles red lights, and it kind of gives like a stealthy running lights kind of feel. Oh, thanks, Dugamus. It's very, very basic at the moment. But yeah, this toggles red and white lights. So I think that's cool. Okay, where were we? Over here? All right. Cannon with cargo pods. Okay, so I had considered this as an idea of making a dummy pod and filling it with warheads and launching it at stuff and causing mass destruction with it instead of it just looks like a regular cargo pod but full of warheads obviously and you know launch it at a pirate station or something and blow it up. I thought that would be neat, and you know, that's a cool idea, actually. Maybe we have a cargo pod launcher under. Maybe we do make this front mounted, and we launch a cargo pod from underneath. I don't know yet. Who knows? Who knows? The opportunities are endless, so we can do whatever we want. That's one of the things I love about this game is I have complete control, and I can do really whatever my creative fancy desires at the moment. Okay, let's start working on these windows. How are they gonna be? I like the idea of like the basement windows, like was suggested. Kind of like this. Do we do. Yeah, that. And that. And brown. And brown. And then, and in, and in, and this. Yeah. That's cool. That's cool. That's cool. That's cool. And then we can do the windows are gonna be like this. Yeah, I don't know how we could make this any different. Oh, they need to be sunken in though, because we're doing that. We're doing that thing. Okay, there. There. And there. And we can go with the advanced armor and do those. Like that. And that'll give us our windows for this. Oh wait, there, there, and there, actually. Aha! Oh, but yeah, you know what? Since we're doing sunken in windows, we can do the wedges. So this will look better. This will look much better like that. Yes, good. Good. Sunken windows for the win, for sure. Yes. Not there, but there. Yes. Yeah, and that's cool. That looks cool. And then we can do. There's my birds again. Okay, let's read. I think that would look. I did that. They need to turn up warhead blast radius. Yeah, we've turned it up on the Star Squadron server. I also made a pod that blows up 15 seconds after you dock it. Oh, that's brilliant. I love it. I feel like you'd get a kick out of Stellaris and the space combat mechanics. I've watched Scott Manley do a Let's Play of Stellaris. And yeah, it looks cool. It looks cool. The strategy, I'm not very good at real-time strategy games, so I might play it. I might check it out. I don't think I would be able to do a video, like a video series or anything on a game like that, just because I'm not clever. I'm not very clever. I can't do those kinds of things. Like, hey, catch. Yeah. Hey, grab this pod real quick, and it explodes on him. I like it. I like it. Okay, and then this. We can just make these go like this, and then follow this shape with the rest of this. So I thought the opportunity to live stream today would be a really cool one, simply because, you know, it's always cool to see how different people build, and everybody kind of has their own like methods with which they do things. Okay, how are we gonna make this work? Okay, I got it. I got it. What if we do this? We could do. How are we gonna make this work? How are we gonna make this work? We could just do this. And just put a brown block there. I mean, that's kind of weird. How else can we do it though? Like this? No, I don't like that. I need something here. Maybe like another triangle there? No. I don't know. We'll come back to it. We'll come back to it. I think you'd be good at it. Seeing your fleet here and the roles you have assigned to your ships, that would be perfect in Solaris. Well, thank you. With the new fleets, you can cloak a ship and radar jam it, and as long as it has the power to stay cloaked or jammed, if it's in a fleet, it will stay that way. So you could make invisible crates. Oh. Use the hex blocks with an indented corner. You're talking about these heptas? Right there? Like that? Oh, you mean this way, like that. No, that's not it either. Here? Yeah, I guess that works. And then what do we do for this, though? Do we do this? Whoops. Do we do this? Yeah, that's probably as close as we can get there. StarMade has so many weird shapes. Okay, and then this. I guess we use the hepta again. That. And there as well. And then that. And then that. All the way across. Okay, and then we can adjust this to suit that. Yeah, okay. I smell what you're stepping in. I'm picking up what you're putting down. I like it. And then we may as well extend this out all the way as far as there. Now these windows, okay, we're gonna do windows still back here, but I'm gonna do them a little differently. Lenscap and Jay should never be enemies. I'd be so conflicted if they were. Yeah, no, we're pals. We have our differences for sure. I mean, you know, everybody's different, but we get along pretty well. We got that portal thing going on together lately. That's fun. That's a lot of fun. Okay, so, no, this is coming along pretty good. I like where this is going. A lot of my building process is flying around and looking at things. So, what is going on here? Did I accidentally remove a block earlier? That sounds like something I would do. Can we do this? How does this look if we do this? Yeah, that looks good. That looks pretty good. And then this can be replaced with one of these. Just like that. Yeah, that looks pretty good. We got some windows. We got a little bit of window action going on. We got a little bit of armor action going on. Okay, so now we've got a sense of proportion. Let's see if we can't hop back inside the bridge area and work on this some more. So what are we going to need? We're going to need lights in here, and the easiest way to do this kind of lights, we need some scaffolding. This is like my favorite block in StarMade, are the scaffolding blocks. Let's see, Lenscap and Jace have a trade treaty. Yes, we do. That's Path to Alliance. Yeah, but remember though, I'm super neutral, so I don't generally form alliances necessarily. All of my alliances are alliances of, what's the word I'm looking for? Like convenience. Yeah. Yeah, man, scaffolding. This is my favorite block in all of StarMade for sure. It's so freaking useful and looks so so industrial, and it really adds this perfect junky atmosphere feeling that I'm going for in all my ships. Okay, I'm thinking we do slabs though. And then we need a red one since we're gonna do the red light too, but we're gonna turn it off. And so the important thing, so here's the thing about this red light, the red lighting system, is that all the Star Squadron and Drakkard are worth it. Never thought building my ship inside out before. I always wondered why my interiors always suck. No, so here's the thing, dude. I have never seen anybody else build like I do. Like, I just kind of randomly jump around and build whatever I feel like building, and it works for me. It doesn't work for everybody, for sure. But I usually start inside, kind of get an idea, and then once I've got my idea out, I'll go and move to something else, and then come back and add details once I'm there. Very, very sporadic builder. Very, very sporadic. Okay, so we had an idea with these windows, though. Let's try this out real quick. See what I'm saying? We started detailing and then we moved on to something else. So, whoops, whoops. These slabs, dude. Okay, I want StarMade to change the way they handle slabs and stuff. Honestly, that's my one. If I could change StarMade, that's what I would change. I want to be able to have a slider that instead of having to like manufacture my blocks as first make the squares and then turn them into triangles, I want to have a slider that does it for me. That's what I want. But I am just a simple spacer, so we're gonna do this and this. And this. Window like that. Yeah, that'd be cool. That'll give our windows a little bit of depth. Okay, and we can do the dark gray as my bird's going off again. They're great though, man. Don't Birds are great if you have pets. I have a lot of pets. My house is like a little zoo almost. I have let's see, what pets do I have? I have four birds. Me and my girlfriend, we live together. We have four birds. There are two are zebra finches, one male and one female. I have fish. We have a betta fish in a 5 gallon tank with two snails. The fish's name is Sushi, and the snails' names are Miguel and Pepe. And I have a mouse. I have a pet mouse. Her name is just Mouse. She has no actual designation. We just call her Mouse. And the birds' names, we have four birds. Like I said, there are two zebra finches. Their names are Octavius and Charlie. And Charlie's the female, Octavius is the male. And we have a spice finch. A spice finch, his name is Calvin. And we have a canary as well. Our canary's name is Friar Tuck, like from Robin Hood. How about these windows? How do we feel about the windows here? So, little zoo going on in my house. How do we feel about this window? I'm not sure. It's okay. I like it from the inside, though, pretty well. It makes it feel beefy, doesn't it? It makes it feel like there's armor there. It makes it feel beefy. Okay, I like that. As a programmer, I have a rule. Just because I discovered a 10 times better way to do something doesn't mean it's worth going back and changing it. Yes, I agree. I agree with you. In this case, it's just have weird issues where everyone's carrying legacy blocks and factories are producing a recipe that doesn't exist. Yes, that's true too. Like the window. Okay, I like the window too. I was kind of on the fence about it, but I appreciate it. I like it too. I think it's gonna work out okay. Now, how do we do this wall though? I don't know. We'll get to that. We'll get to that. So where do we go from here? We're working on, let's do a little bit more work down here. We need to figure out how these stations are gonna be and what the floor underneath this is gonna look like, the subfloor, whatever. What's all that gonna do? Is that a slab? Not anymore. And what do these stations look like? How is this wall? I think it's cool. We should do the floating light stairs in here. Oh gosh, I feel bad. I spent that whole episode talking about floating light stairs and how inventive and neat I thought they were. They're just freaking stairs, man. But whatever. I enjoyed making that one. Okay, this has to come out at least this far for the stairs, and I think one further for sure. So we definitely need it to be at least that. Do we have enough lights in here? We kinda do. We could do more scaffolding like this for more lights. Lights are important, especially. So here's my thing with lights. Like, because I do YouTube darkens your videos like crazy, and I want my videos to be viewed, you know, that's the whole thing. We're gonna need to come out one further with this. I always put way more lights than are necessary, or I like to anyway, just so that everything is bright. Especially with the weird colors, like we were kind of talking about the weird colors before. If I'm gonna do some weird color like red, so the red lights are awesome because they tend to give you a light source, but it also makes the room feel dark. Still. So you can kind of simulate darkness but not have it so dark that no one can see by using red lights. So, like, if we turn off these white ones, for example, whoops. If we turn off all the white ones, we'll put. Ah, come on, hit the light, dude! If we turn off the lights and turn on the red, then it's still bright in here, but it simulates darkness. So the red lights are cool for that. This is overdone though. That's way too much light. Let's do one red in the middle. That'll be enough. You do want it a little dark, so. I also would like white light. Oh, you know what you can do for light wedges? Check this out, man. Crystals. Crystals. So parsing crystal, for example, makes a great white light wedge. Look at that. Boom. Light wedges. I just saved your life. All right, let's turn these lights back on. And should we put lights maybe on the sides too, or is this just, am I just way overdoing it? I may be way overdoing it with that. Yeah, I think that's too much. That's too much. All right, so let's see. So we want to get rid of the symmetry and talk about these guys down here. So we need a weapons guy. So let's think. What stations do we want? Let's pull out some decorative displays and mark our stations with these. So we want a weapons dude. He mostly needs to face forward. He could be over here, maybe. We want a comms officer. He can be orange. We want a. What else did we need? Gonna get a remote to set the lights to be red or white. Yeah, I'm gonna put a button in. Probably one of the guys down here will do that. We need an engineering station, maybe. He could be green. That's pretty good. And that gives us four people flying at once, four crew at once, so we need 12 bunks for 8-hour shifts. 12 bunks is a lot of bunks. It's gonna be a pretty big ship, I guess. I mean, we could run it on a skeleton crew, though, and only have like 8 bunks, and because you don't need all the people all the time. Jace Machine, what's up? What's up? Have a guy control the pods. Yeah, that's true. That's true. We might do maybe that'll be this green station here, and we'll have an engineer that lives or works specifically in the engine area once we figure out where that's gonna be. Jace Machine, welcome to the stream, man. One bunk is plenty. Who needs crew? Yeah, man. I mean, in reality, like, I'm the only actual person here, so that's fair enough. I might do, like, little robots like I have at the Salty Shipyard. That'd be cool. Like the cockpit? Thanks, man. It's coming along. Okay, so we kind of got three stations down here. I think that's good. I think that'd be fine. Let's move this one over slightly, so as not to interfere. And for chairs for these guys, do we just want to give them, like, color-coordinated chairs even? So, like, red for the weapons dude. I know our captain's chair is red, but it's a special chair, so... red, and then we'll do, like... Oh, you know what? Ingots. I've seen people use ingots for chairs, and that seems like a pretty cool thing. We could try and use ingots, maybe. What do you guys think, the ingots for chairs? Yeah, let's move this more to here. The black ones look really good. I just woke up, can't hang long. Great to see Len streaming. Thanks, man. Have you ever heard of Shores of Horizon? I have not. What is that? Hazeron. Oh, Shores of Hazeron. I've not. What is Shores of Hazeron? Yeah, we could go for ingots. That's kind of cool. This one's velvety, though. It looks velvety. Okay, so we've got that. And what else can we kind of throw in down here to make it decorative? We don't want, like, gray and garbage. We want fancy. How can we make it fancy? Oh, thrusters, thrusters. Thrusters are my favorite decorative tool. Because they're both attractive and functional. So let's throw in some thrusters. Oops. Let's start with thrusters here at the top. No, there. And these will come back about this far. And then metal grate. Metal grill. Yeah, this will go all the way through. Sure. Is that too much? How's it look? From below as well? Yeah, it looks good. It was free to play, not anymore, sadly. It was an MMO with city building, shipbuilding, and space exploration. Well, that sounds fun. What was neat is that you needed to crew your ships, like with actual people or with, like, NPCs. And you could do it with AI crew members. Oh, answered my question. Okay. National holiday to Nate. Dougamus, you have a billion kids? Holy crap, dude. A good player engineer, for example, could give you an edge in a fight because they could hack repairs. Oh, nice. Okay, that sounds similar to Interstellar Rift, actually. I haven't gotten too far into the combat of it, but yeah, that sounds a lot like the combat in that game. There's, like, you can hack people's ships and stuff. It sounds very good. It sounds very fun. Do we want more metal grill? I'm all about some metal grill like that, so... How did that... Wait a minute. How is that not a thruster? Okay, yeah, and this needs to be gray hull, actually. This one. Whoops, took another screenshot. Clumsy fingers lens cap. That's what they called me in college. They didn't call me that in college. Okay, so that's kind of cool, I guess. It gives it a little bit more life. I like that you can see down into the lower area. Let's grab our thrusters back, because I think we can do more with these. Let's put them... Shoot, dude, I don't know. Because I think we could do them across like this, too. I don't know, that's a little rough. Oh, you know what else I'd like to do, though, are jump modules. Where the thrusters intersect. Whoops. Why did they change the orientation on those recently? I don't know why that was a thing. But that makes a little better intersection than just kind of weird like that. Okay. Sorry, I'm trying to build and read the chat at the same time. I'm having trouble keeping up. Dougmas has 6 kids. Wow, I have 0 kids. But I have like 50 pets. Have to have lunch and start programming. Are you gonna stay during your lunch, Telerath, or are you gonna leave for lunch? Oh man, yeah, Interstellar Rift is fun. It's pretty fun. I'm excited to play it. You guys will just have to stay tuned to my Let's Play and watch, and watch, I guess. It's a pretty fun game though. I'm definitely digging it. I'm definitely enjoying myself. Let's see. I don't want to see the thruster plumes. So that'll fix that method. That'll fix that. And then, like, what do we do here? These. Let's do these jump drive modules. Oh, come on. Yeah, that looks pretty good. And for decoration here, we'll do more. We'll do thrusters. Whatever. That looks cool. That looks fine. And let's find some dark gray hull. I don't know what the buttons. Okay, like that for corners. Yeah, that looks pretty good. Starting to look like a floor, right? Let's turn off symmetry so we can throw in some more of these. There. Ordered pizza, okay. Oh man, that's a great idea. I might order a pizza. Heard about Interstellar Rift before I heard about StarMade. Oh, okay. StarMade was a more complete game, so that was one I jumped for. Yeah, I just recently found Interstellar Rift. One of my subscribers, he comments sometimes. Nate gave it to me, so he's a cool dude. Let's see, do we want to just do hull? I mean, there's no rule that says you can't do just hull. I just don't like to use just hull, you know, if I have another block that'll work as well. Because it's almost too much the same, but let's see, we can get rid of that whole thing there completely. Great, let's see. Maybe we do, whoops, I missed. Maybe we do just so it's a little bit more even, but still not symmetric. Yeah, we can do that. That looks good. That looks pretty good. Okay. So this is coming along. This is looking pretty good so far. Ah, now wait a minute though. If we're gonna do this map thing, yes, if we're gonna do the map thing, we don't want grills in the floor. Fortunately, we can just do more thrusters. Like that, and we'll need a jump module. Jump drive compute, we'll need that too. And right there. So that'll work. That way it kind of looks like a piping intersection thing. It's almost like a vent or something. Why are grills bad? Grills are not bad, but I don't want the grills there because we're going to put, let's go ahead and put it in. We're going to put a, like a map thing right here. Like this. And if there's a grill underneath it, it just doesn't look like it's structurally supported. So we want to make sure that that everything looks supported. All right, so we need blue crystal, and we need the force fields as well. And we're going to do super slabs, like call it. Now, we could do the blue crystal on both sides like this. Kind of give it like a map feel thing. But I find that you can use the force fields as well. You can make slabs out of them and put it in places, and then it kind of looks like something is going on your map. So let's see. Let's do like this. It doesn't have to be a mirror, but I like to make it kind of a mirrored thing like that. So yeah, so that looks pretty cool. That looks pretty good. Okay, so we've got that now. So that's kind of the top area of the bridge done. I would almost call it done. At least pretty close. We may need to revisit some of this junk, because I just kind of... Yeah, that didn't look very good. I'll have to smooth out the inside of this later. Or something, I don't know. We'll revisit. A hologram map, yeah, exactly. Exactly, exactly. The grills are good, and I'm going to leave them in the other spots, but underneath this, yeah, it needs a little bit more structural support. And in fact, we might even do this. No, because you can see there. That's not going to work for me. But maybe we just put one. Yeah, that works. That looks good. Okay, so let's think about ship systems a little bit. Let's go ahead and pre-plan these systems. What do we want? What systems do we want? So we definitely, definitely, definitely need a jump drive. Above anything else, we gotta have a jump drive. So let's put in a jump drive. We can even go ahead and link these few computers to it already, so they're functional and not just decorative. Okay, what other systems do we need? Armament. For armament, we're probably going to just rely on turrets. I don't think we're actually going to have any real guns. This is it's a freighter, so it needs to be able to run and defend itself. So we also are going to need a radar jammer. So we put that right there. Okay, let's take this and put in some decorative things. I like the server racks, especially like these because they're animated. I really like the animated stuff. But you don't want to put too much, you know, you don't want to put too many similar blocks right near each other. Otherwise, it just kind of looks like you're being ridiculous. All right, so we got that. Maybe we run some piping above them. That could work. What other systems do we need? Overdrive to help with the thrusters. Yeah, that's good. That's good. Overdrive effect. That's good. Yeah. We definitely want overdrive. Maybe we put the overdrive computer there. What else would be nice to have? What else would be nice to have? We could do... Let's see, what other options? Let's just search computer. God, there's a lot. Okay. Power supply, power drain, pull effect, push effect, stop effect could be nice. I don't think necessary. It might be nice to have a stop effect on the forklift, actually, but there's definitely not room for it. Astrotech, like a repair beam? Oh, that's an interesting thought. Not on this ship, though. It's just a freighter. Maybe on a bigger one if we do like a. If we end up doing like a carrier or something, it can have a repair bay. That'd be cool. Scanner computer? Yeah, let's put a scanner in it. That'd be good. I could see a freighter wanting to have scanning capabilities. Let's put the scanner computer over here, though. Yeah, that would make sense. The weapons guy needs to have the scanner. Okay. Okay. Let's put it here. Oh, now it's backwards. It doesn't matter what direction these face, so I'm kind of decorating with them a little bit. Functional and neat looking. That's what I like. Let's see, what else do we want? Decorative. I like the charts. I like the servers. Oh, the fans. I like the fans. I need some thrusters on my bar. Let's do metal grill. No, the grill. And jump. Let's take some of these. All right. So decorative charts. I'm just gonna make a wall of systems basically for this, and then figure out some neat way to, I don't know, do the back. Oh, and we need a button. Let's see, how do I do it in this other ship? Where is. How do I have this? This is a button on a flip-flop, isn't it? Yeah, not in a flip-flop. Why is there open. What? Empty space there. Okay, so we'll need to do that too. So let's get a button. Where can we put it there? Let's get a flip. That'll have a knot in it as well. All right. And then we can put the lights in, the button for the lights in. Eve Online. Oh my gosh, dude. Eve Online. Yes. Spreadsheet simulator. Let's put some more server racks. Ah, that's fine. We want to be able to use this window, so maybe we get rid of those. Then we don't need that chair. Okay. And the gunner, let's get some charts. Sure. And let's get a decorative this. We've got a red one. Let's give him a. He needs a map. Two. Yeah. That looks fine. I always like adding buttons and things for my passengers to interact with while flying. Yeah, for sure. It's always nice to have stuff like that. Oh, we need a. Okay, we need a. We need these. I don't have room on my bar yet, so we'll get to that in a second. But I'm thinking we do here. Can I do here? And my button there? Nope, I gotta do it there. Button. And flip flop. And a knot. So switch those. Let's turn this. This goes to this. All right, so now the flip-flop. Let's have the flip-flop be the white lights. Come on. There it is. All right, and we'll have the knot be the red lights. And let's try it out. Yes!
Oh, it's great. It's beautiful. It's perfect. It's awesome. It worked out great. I think we're gonna need another light further back here-ish, but we'll cross that bridge when we get to it. Okay, the next thing we want is our transporter. So let's throw this in. So there's our computer for it. Not that. Here's the module for it. And I like to do like this for no apparent reason. I just think it looks good. And we need gravity for when you first transport in. It'd be nice to have gravity near the core as well, so. Can we put a gravity block? Okay, let's do like this. There we go, and now you can access the gravity block from the captain's seat if you need to. I like that. It would also be nice to have a permission module on the transporter. Oh, hey Asher! Sorry, I was behind on the chat. I was too busy focused on building things. Let's see. Hey Asher, welcome to my stream. That's right. You made a flip-flop last month. That's like the shoe. Now build a Kasli. I don't know what that is. Sorry. I do need some permission modules all over the place, though, and unfortunately, I'm just gonna have to spam them, I guess. There, there, and there. That way anybody can use those things. How could I do this better? Okay, I could do this better like this. Put my gravity here. Then I only need the one permission module. We can put a server rack here. Let's put the other server rack there. Oh, a castle. Okay. A castle. Yeah, a castle in StarMade could be cool. Let's grab gray. We'll put a full gray block. What? A full block there for stairs. And there. And whatever, we'll just do that. That'd be fine. Let's do dark gray for those two. Let's do thrusters instead, actually. There we go. Yes. That's much better. And then we have useful blocks. Useful blocks. Okay, that looks good. So we ended up with three stations. Now, what are we gonna do to make these stations kind of look like they do something? Let's grab some paint. Gray, red, and orange. Okay. Let's see if we can't link these up somehow. Let's do like this. And like this. And then let's stick an orange one doing kind of the same thing. Maybe it does like this first and then like this. Oh, whoops. Okay. Like that? How's that? How's that work out? Yeah, that works out. And then we can still see pretty well. Okay, we can have this kind of do this kind of thing, maybe, so it looks like it goes into the floor. Yeah, I need corners, man. Guten something. Guten Tag is good day. Guten Morgen is good morning. I really like this bridge area. That's something I always struggle with on my ships. A flip-flop is two NAND gates that feed into one another. You send a pulse to change the output. A little more complicated than that, of course. Yeah, I'm sure. That's cool, man. I'm very interested in your hobby, though, Tolerath. That's a very cool. Now, you said you're doing it for students, so are you like a teacher? Let's put charts here. That's a little crowded right here in the corner, though, yes? Whatever, crowded is fine. I got no problems with crowded. If we put the button over here, we can put a sign on it. Maybe we can. How can I make this happen? Yeah, I think I can make this happen. A student, okay. We could do, we could put the charts there. I like the decorative charts because they're, again, animation. Animation is my favorite. Let's switch these two. That just looks a little better because then we have the animation blocks kind of not touching. I don't know. It's a weird Lenscap thing, whatever. thruster. Yeah, thruster there. Kind of give it some trim or something. And then I guess this is the back wall where this is. And then we can put our button for the lights over here. Hook it back up to the flip-flop with the test. Yes, it still works. I don't know why I wouldn't, but you never know. And do we need permission on the button? Nah. Okay, let's pull up a display module. We can just label this already. And I think that's the right orientation. Yeah. So we can just do lights on like the third line. And I think we can do. Whoops. What happened? And if we put it in line with this D. That should be about where we want it to be. Right? Right? No? Where is it? Where's my word? Oh, I don't like that. Oh, I don't like that at all. I don't want that. I don't want it. I don't like it. I don't want it there. I don't want that at all. Let's put. I don't want the conduit showing. Button, where does the button live? I guess that was the best place for it, but then we can't label it for lights. Does this button have a label on it? I don't remember. I think I had a label and then removed it. Yeah, so that'll be fine then. We just won't label it. You just push random buttons and hope they do things. That's generally my philosophy with life anyway. All right, so we can grab our public permission module again. I don't care if other people use it. I mean, I don't play on any like PvP servers or anything, so the only other people that'll be on my ship are Star Squadron members generally, so no worries. Okay, now this is starting to get kind of busy. We want it to look important, but we don't want it to be too busy. So we need to remedy that a little bit. What am I looking for? Jump. So let's do the floor real quick, and we'll try and make the floor a little bit more tame. because detail is good, but too much detail is definitely is a thing. You know, you can put too much. So I'm thinking we do, that's gray, so let's do dark gray. And we're gonna stick with our kind of industrial colors that we've got. Nah, not like that. I don't like it. But we could do maybe like this. Just to give it something. I think that's fine. I think that's fine. Yeah, that looks pretty good. Looks pretty good. Can you access the gravity? Yes. Yes. Okay. We need a faction module. Took another screenshot. Like 15 of those now. where does this gonna go? Is this a thing? This is a decorative screen, right? Let's put our faction module here. Cool, so there's our bridge. I think this is a pretty good bridge so far. We're making some progress, All right, let's grab our thrusters again and do this back wall. And we could even go so far as to do that, maybe. Can I do Subnautica? I do not own Subnautica, but I have looked at it. It definitely looks like the kind of game I would enjoy playing. Yeah, I'd be down for Subnautica. I think that looks like a fun game. We could do orange paint cans and make a pipe that runs across this. And goes back into the aether. Just kind of ends there, but it looks like it goes farther than it does. Full Sail University, huh? Okay. I've seen like commercials for them and stuff on TV. Let's see, what else do we want to put here? We're gonna leave that, we're probably gonna seal this up. But I'm not sure if I want this to bulge out with, or anything yet. I don't know what I'm gonna do there yet, so I'm not gonna do that yet. So, like I said, you know, start at the front and work your way back, right? We're almost done with this bit though. This has been a really productive live stream so far. I'm having a lot of fun doing this. I'll have to do this kind of thing more often. I hope you guys are enjoying it as much as I am. Okay, what else can we do for this wall? Like, I don't want it to be super blank, but I don't want it to be super busy either. We could just do, I mean, I'm cool with just like gray or dark gray or something. We just do hull, like, is that bad? Does that look bad, or? I mean, it looks fine. It looks fine. We just close this all the way off. Yeah, how do we do this though? And what do we do over here? This looks pretty good actually. And this is gonna be open. I don't mind if this is open. Let's throw some more piping in, like some more paint cans, just of various. Lens casually builds one of his masterpieces. Oh, thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Oh, there are pipe blocks, but yeah, again, they don't use colors exactly. Yeah, there are pipes. We might could use some of the pipes. So I want the pipes to do this. If I do this with a pipe, come on. This? I want it to connect. That's what I want. I want pipes to connect. Like fences in Minecraft. That'd be amazing. That'd be so amazing. That's what I want to see. Okay, so if we're doing a wall there, we can extend this. So I guess we are extending this. We're just going to use regular gray. And we could do like a wedge, maybe. Yes, wedge. Okay, that is looking pretty good down here. Looking pretty good, pretty good. And those pipes on the back, you probably never see them, but they add a little bit of interesting details. If we do this straight up and this straight up and this one, if it goes straight up, it goes into a wedge, so I'm not a fan of that. So let's remove that pipe entirely. Or we could do, let's do this instead, actually. Yes, there we go. That looks much better. Let's see if we do that. That adds a little bit more depth, even. Okay. I like it. I like it. I like that. Got some piping. Got some colors. That's fine. I'm almost ready to call this finished, guys. This is looking good. I might move the transporter more central so it doesn't feel so crowded in the corner there. Although, what do you guys think? What do you think in the stream chat? Should we move the transporter, or is it cool in the corner? What do you think? This is why I have you guys. I need your input. So. Fine. Yeah, okay. I think it's fine. I almost like having the more plain wall anyway, because you want it doing stuff, you want it to look like there's stuff going on, but you don't want it too busy. So some people are saying it's cool in the corn. Create a transporter room. It's okay, but you like my usual transporter. Okay. Let's go over here and look at how I pulled it off on this ship. Uh-huh. Okay. I just pulled it away from the wall one more block. Do I have permission modules on this? Oh, I don't. I bet that's why there's blank spots there. I like making a big deal out of the transporter, like it's not just two blocks. Yeah, I agree, man. They're really cool. They should be cool. So a transporter room, though, is an interesting idea. I'd like to have the transporter pretty close to the core. But we could maybe do a transporter room. Maybe we put a door right here. And then give a little transporter room. Okay, let's do that. I think that's a fantastic idea. And we can just kind of do whatever with this. This is awesome! This will let us do... Okay, transporter room it is. That's a great idea. We're doing that. And we can do a display module and see. Oh no, it's got to be on this side of the button. That's not going to work. Okay, but we can put the light button here. Then. And still, like, the plain walls is still working. I think it's still working for us down here. I don't think that's a problem still, so. We can do thruster, and where's our button? Disbut. There's our button. No! Let's make this let's dress this up a little bit. Let's put a fan. Oh, we could do a fan here. Give the pipe something to do.
Do an extended crew cabin and facilities and stuff. It's like a tanker ship. It'll take a few weeks to transport goods.
Yeah, I agree. We definitely need we'll need a crew quarters. We'll need a galley. Maybe a rec room, like a small one. It's not going to be a gigantic ship. Like we've got three people manning the ship, or maybe four if there's an engineer back in the engineering as well. So maybe 12 crew total. So I mean, that's still much bigger than any of the other ships in my fleet. But I agree, we need some stuff. You need to move the flip-flop and the not gate to put the button there. Yeah, you're right. You're right, I do, don't I? Let's remove all this stuff for a second, and we're going to build a little transporter room off of this room, so we may as well go ahead and start on that real quick. And get the door in place first, and then we can kind of decide on, where the button's gonna go. Oh, and that'll have to be a full block. I don't guess it has to be. It's gonna be, though. Yeah, that's a little weird. Oh, it's fine. Okay, and then we're doing our doors like this. Like this. We can put a display module here that says transporter on it. It needs to be... Maybe this is where we want... Let's see, where does that put our words? Beautiful. Let's do this. Let's do something cool like this. Let's see if we can't make this a little bit fancier. Can we do like... I need some ASCII codes real quick. Hold on, let me find a character map. Char map. Do. You guys can't see what I'm doing now. I think it's, but I've got a character map pulled up. So I'm looking for some interesting shapes that we can make, like a border around where it says transporter. I'm not seeing the shapes I want. What font does StarMade use for this? Does anybody know? How long will the live stream be? Probably another hour. I probably got about another hour in me. Maybe a little bit longer. It just depends on how we're progressing. We're doing pretty well though, so I'm enjoying myself still. So probably at least another hour. Script? No. Terminal? Yeah, here we go. These are the shapes I want. Okay, so I'm gonna need one of these. Please work. Please paste. Dang it! Different shapes. Okay. Fine. I don't feel like screwing with this right now. We're just gonna say transporter. I kind of like the simplicity thing anyway, though, a little bit. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, whoops. Let's do something fancy. We could do rails. Could be cool. Oh yeah, that's gotta be like that. But there's gonna be a door here anyway, it doesn't matter. That door, man, it feels huge. Doesn't it? I think it's huge. We're gonna have to, let's tighten this up a little bit. Let's do a small door, a small transporter room. Like that. Yeah, I've seen, Warwolf, I've seen that Toaster Borst, video. It's awesome. He is so creative and so awesome. And I may at some point eventually play with the display modules a little bit more. For now, I'm just gonna stick with the simple stuff. I have, that guy is so impressive though with the kinds of crazy things he comes up with his display module stuff. Let's call this transporter room. We'll just do it like that. I think that'll work. I'm kind of I don't know, man. I'm not feeling it right now. Let's go look at the doors on this ship because I think I labeled them. Detachable transporter room? How does that work? Yeah, no, that's fine. We could do something like brackets or something, maybe. Something simple. Brackets. Like that. I don't know. Whatever. It's good. That'd be good. Let's put the floor back in. And the walls back in. Just like that. No way, man. No way, man. This. If we do that, we gotta do it here, too. That looks a little better, though. Yeah. Now, do we want a thruster there? Does it go all the way to the door? Yes, I believe it does. But see, now this corner feels empty, so we need something like... Oh! We need a potted plant. Won't the wedge on the floor make it difficult to walk in? I mean, here, let's try it. Let's check it out. Where's my gravity? Let's check it out. Can we walk up these stairs? No, you still gotta jump. I want this. I want to be able to walk up the slabs. Okay, but anyway... Yeah, no, no problem. No problem. You walk in just fine. Yeah, a potted plant. Okay, so how are we gonna do a potted plant? Let's see. I don't even remember what the plants are called. Is there brown lights? That'd be weird. Yellow, maybe. Okay. Maybe we can make like a little tree. How's that look? Okay, I think this work. We need something that we can use for a pot. For a plant pot. Small cactus. Ooh. Okay, let's check a couple of things out. Let's try a couple of things. Maybe some grass. Let's grab some foliage. We can try Grass surrounded by slabs on the sides for a pot. Okay, yeah, good thought, good thought. We can use brown hull. Good thought, and we'll grab some grass. Grass, and we'll use brown hull for a pot. Yeah, that looks like a pot. That looks like a potted plant. That's pretty good. Let's pull it away from the wall. Let's put it there. Just so it, you know, doesn't, like, who throws a plant that's, like, stuck in the corner like that? That's mean to the plants. Okay, I was thinking we try a couple of things. We can try this, and maybe it's like a topiary. Yeah, no, that doesn't quite work, does it? That's a little silly. Okay, we could do maybe the small cactus. That's not too bad. What if we grab some green paint? Put the cactus on that. Yeah, then it's almost too tall, though. The only thing that's wrong with StarMade is the lack of people that know about it. Yeah, I agree. Well, you know, spread the word, fellas. Like, if you watch other people on YouTube, like other big YouTubers that play other similar games, you know, plug StarMade in their comments. Like, I'm telling you, like, that'll, maybe if one person sees your comment and decides to check out StarMade because of it, then victory, right? You did a great job. Okay, a little bit of grass. That's not so bad, just the grass. I almost like just the small cactus, though, like that. What do you guys think about the plant? I'm thinking that looks pretty good, and it gives us a little bit of life in the room, so I'm thinking that might work. Hey, Yannick, how are ya? Yeah, I'm liking that. I'm liking that. It's simple, but it works. Simple, but it works. And it fills up the space very nicely. And I think we'll just leave this part open. Now, the lava lighting that I've got going on right here, that was just kind of for fun. I don't know if that's going to be a permanent thing. I think I'm going to get rid of it. Not slabs, though. What did I just do? Oh, over here. Where is the shape I want? There it is. Yeah. I think that's what I did. I've been watching for 15 minutes. Look how much you've done. I'm guessing that you're making a flagship. Kind of. It's going to be a freighter, but it is going to be the biggest one in the fleet so far. So, not quite a flagship. I figure it'll be probably twice as big as this. Maybe even bigger than that, actually, because we got to hold a bunch of pods, and the cargo pods are pretty big. So, who knows? It could be bigger. It could be even bigger than that. What do we think about, where's that dark gray advanced? What do we think about this really quick? It just kind of jumped out at me. If we do this, or should it be square at the bottom like that? The rounded kind of works, but if we do it there, we almost have to do it in other places too. But I definitely dig that shape, though, actually. And I left the leeway to be able to do that. I like it. I like that better. I think we do that. I have to go around and do it on both sides now because I didn't set symmetry before I started messing with stuff. This corner we can't do it in, but I think that's fine. You like the edges, like the rounded edges like this, or you like the harsh edges without the wedges in them? I like it. I like the rounded edges. I like the rounded corners like that. Okay, but we need to do something with this brown then. This needs to change some way. Okay, maybe like we do... Here, let's set symmetry real quick because I'm going to need to do a little symmetry thing. Okay, maybe like... Okay, I like where this is going. Like that. It's a little bit of a decorative kind of thing. And then we'll need to do like a full block. And then like this can be a wedge to fill in the gaps. Like the rounded ones? Yeah, I like the rounded ones too. I think it just adds another little touch. Oh, and we can do something cool here, like a fan. Just because. Something like that there. Just to give it another little piece. A little piece of something. You know, a little animation on the side or something. I like that. Okay, so let's round out. Okay, so we did that. That looks good. I think that looks good. We could even maybe, let's see, how could we make it look even better though? I can get rid of the foliage. I think I'm done with that. If we did this, if we made this just a little bit more interesting. Maybe like that. Because I'm trying to mimic this kind of thing we've got going on, right? Like this ship has it, and this ship kind of has it. The mass enhancers to fans. Okay, we can check out the mass enhancers. Yeah, that's okay. Mass enhancer's pretty good there too. I don't know though. I think I like the fans better. It's because their motion is more evident. Do you plan on making the ship symmetrical or asymmetrical on the exterior? Oh man. Are you even asking me that right now? I'm doing asym for sure. It's going to be kind of like... So Jace Machine came up with this analogy, but he said my ships are interesting because they're kind of like a motorcycle where you can see through them. You can see the systems through them. And I thought that was a really apt description of the kind of style that I'm going for, like a motorcycle. So you can see through them. But definitely asymmetric. Definitely asymmetric. Okay, what were we just touching on before we did that? I'm totally lost my train of thought. Oh yes, the transporter room. Transporter room. Okay, I'm all over the place, but this is how I like to build. So dark gray hull. We don't need that. Let's see, let's open this so I get the right blocks in the right place. That goes there, and this goes here. Just like that. Okay, that'll work. I can work around that. Like that. Yeah, I agree. Have I seen Jace's new skin? Yes, it's awesome. It's so awesome. Jace's skin is so good. It really makes me jealous, and I'm very disappointed in myself that my skin is not as amazing as his. His skin is so well done. Okay. Whoops. I don't want any of these blocks. Okay. Transporter room. So start with the floor. Let's start with gray. So you gotta be able to walk in. There's gotta be a little bit of room around here. Okay. That's big. That's bigger than I want it to be, but it'll work for now. Let's go ahead and decide where the rest of this goes. Let's go transporter. Let's put it off to one side instead of like in the center of the room, I'm thinking. So this doesn't have to be a big room. It just has to be a room, you know. So that's probably big enough. Yeah, that'll be good. That'll be good there. I can get rid of that block. Okay. Let's do some hull and colors, maybe. Yeah, that works. Let's do thrusters. Now the thrusters, if we're doing thrusters on the walls like I like to do, this is going to be interesting because you can't put them on this wall because then you get the thruster plumes unless you put something in front of them. Like even if you turn the thruster, you still get the plumes. Do you watch anime? I mean, hit or miss. Some anime is good. A lot of it's really bad. Okay, that's good. We want it to be tight in here. Like, it doesn't need to be a big room. For the wall, let's see. Let's put a fan. And then we got to do a gray hull ceiling. I'm not sure. I'm not ready to do that yet. How can we make this interesting? So we got to think about how does the ceiling of this room work? How does this room interact with this room? Where do the walls go? Like, what does the back of this room look like? You know, we got a lot to think about here. Yeah, I mean, you can turn the plumes off in the settings, but I want, if anybody else is looking at my ship and they don't have plumes off, then it kind of defeats the point, right? Area triggers is a good idea, though. So you can put area triggers that are not assigned to anything like that. It'll hide the plumes. Sometimes you got to break and replace the blocks, but yeah, that would work. That works. And they won't hurt anybody or get in any way or anything. And if you're not, if you're just in astronaut mode, then you won't be able to see them. So, yeah, that works. That works all right. Okay, we'll do that. Good suggestion. Have multiple pads? Wait a second. I missed something. That's how you know it's a lens ace. Okay. Oh, yeah, the giant skull, the branding. Yeah. Oh, later, John. Maybe we're still going for another little while, so if you come back, maybe you can come back in. But thanks for stopping by. Definitely appreciate it. Okay, let's we need to hop back into the core. Yes. Okay, I think this is good. This is good. And we can go 1, 2 there. I think we can make this work, though. I think we can make it work. Let's just use the dark gray for walls. Oh, what have I done? What have I done? Everything is falling apart. What? Is that advanced armor? No, I want hull. And we gotta think about how do we light this room as well. We can do... I want this to be a little bit taller, actually, this room. So I think we'll make it a little bit taller. Let's go ahead and just build the shape of the room first, and then we can figure out how we're gonna light it and how we're gonna decorate the walls and stuff. Now this layer is gonna have to be gray hull, so it's the same all the way around, because we don't want to impede on this floor. But we could, like, we could do something like this. Maybe? How's this work? Okay, I mean, that's not bad. And then we'll need these things in the corners, like this and like this. Yeah, that's not bad. And then we can do our lights. We can actually do the lights like this then. If I can spell things, white and red. We'll just put it there. And there. They can be full blocks. It doesn't matter. And then what do we put in this space? We need one more thing. We could do like a fan or something. Unturned. Will I play unturned? I could. I don't have unturned, but I could play it. Maybe a mass enhancer. Yeah, that's not so bad. Very small room. Let's look in astronaut mode at this room. And see if we like the feel of it. I mean, it's a teleporter room. It doesn't have to be fancy, right? But it's... It feels really dark in here, though, doesn't it? Okay, we're gonna have to play with that a little bit more. Let's see. What else? What else could we... How else could we do this? We could do slab lights. Slab lights a level lower. That might be better. We could even do two white lights. I mean, it's a small room, but, oh my gosh. Oh, you know what? That needs to be a wedge anyway. So that'd be fine. That'll work. Let's do like that. And then this, like this. And we need this and this. That's a little better. Let's turn that red light off. Yeah, I think that works. I think that works okay. We can put another fan in opposite this. So two fans. Let's get some metal mesh. Or grates, I mean. I always screw those up. I've been careful not to do it this while we're streaming, but I almost exclusively get those backwards. When I want the grates, I always go for the mesh. Okay, like that, and now we got to do something about the light. That's not gonna work. Yeah, we'll have to do something different for the ceiling as well. If we make the room taller, let's see, how do we have it in this? Okay, yeah, that's different, and that's better. Okay, let's do it like that then. But I also have it right up against the wall, and I think I'm gonna do that. Let's grab the dark hall. And transporter blocks. Come on. Okay, we'll put the controller here so it's at eye level. It doesn't matter which direction it faces, so we'll pick the way that looks the best. We need this here, and we need these like this. But these don't actually do anything. Like this. Okay. Like that. I dig that. I dig that. Let's throw lights in the walls, actually. That might look a little better. Can I put lights here? There's no rule that says I can't. Okay, so that's better. That's better. Yeah, that's much better. Since everything is made out of one block, you can make your own. Oh yeah, for sure. Let's do the orange paint cans as well. This is coming along. This is coming along. Slowly but surely. Okay, we can do. Let's make this room taller. How do we get out of the bridge? Yeah, this isn't gonna work then, because we gotta be able to, you know, like, exit the bridge. Like, we could maybe make it one block taller and have, like, stairs or something. So we can have a roof, like a ceiling. And what do we wanna use? I mean, if I just do dark gray, is that too much dark gray in here? It's got that dividing line around the ceiling, so I think it'd be okay. I think it'd be okay. We can leave that pipe exposed sort of like that too. No, you can't see it. It doesn't matter. Okay, that's pretty decent transporter room though. I mean, it's very small, very simple. Let's add some server racks and stuff. Give it something going on in here. It's kind of plain as it stands, so that's good. We need gravity. Let's put the gravity module here. That's good. And maybe we put another light there. And then we need a corresponding red light, or do we? Yeah, we kind of do. We could put it here, maybe? Is that good? Yeah, that's bright enough.
Is that bright enough for you guys? You have a teleporter on the bridge, you have a way in or out. Yeah, that's true. That's true. We could even put the door to the rest of the ship through the teleporter room. There's an interesting thought. I'll have to think about that one for a second. Okay, well, let's leave it as it is and come back to it. Let's work on something else for a little bit. So let's see. What do we want to work on next? Do we want to have to enter the bridge through the teleporter room? We could, but if we do that, this is an awful small door to access the bridge. So I think we want bridge access actually from up here somehow. I wanted a door right here, but if we've got the teleporter room just beneath it, you know, that's not quite going to work out for me. Unless I make the teleporter room even smaller and just drop the ceiling one block, like that could work. Like this. And then, I mean, that's fine. Let's turn off these reds. Oh, you know what? We need to attach these to our button, too. Where'd the button go? Did I remove the button and never put it back in? Come on, guys. You gotta be on top of this stuff. I always forget. Okay, we gotta make a new button. Where's the button go? That looks good. All right, so button to the flip-flop, flip-flop to the knot. Okay, this one goes to all the whites. V, V, like from Final Fantasy IX, V, V. Okay, that's not what I was talking about. 1, 2, okay. No! All right. V, V, V. All right, and then this one to the reds. And now our button is conveniently hidden behind our potted plant, so that works out. All right, let's try it. Yeah. Works great. Works great. I like the red, though. I think that's a really cool thing. Do a hallway coming from the stairs. You like straight back... Like, straight back from here? That could maybe work. Let's do the ceiling for this. We'll just call it Gray Hall real quick and see how that looks from inside. Yeah, no, that's fine. That seems fine. I almost want something in this corner too, but I feel like it's crowded enough. Let's walk in there. Yeah, no, this is fine. This is great. And then we got the gravity there. Yeah, this is great. This is great. There's no corresponding red light to this, though, so we'll need to do that. Let's actually... Do we need it? I don't think we need it. Do we need another red light in here? I don't think we do. Yeah, I think that's good. Cool. Okay. And now we can start thinking about... I think the bridge is done. I think it's finished. I think it looks good. I think we're finished with this part. We got the transporter room. We got the bridge. We got a little bit of exterior rolling. That took 3 hours. This is 3 hours of work, and it's how many square blocks? Like, gosh, it's such a small area, but there's so much work that goes into these ships. No, when you say no, what are you referring to, Ben? The stream, the chat is like 25 seconds behind, and I can't remember 25 seconds ago, so I'm not sure what you're knowing to. That's true, that's true. The bridge is the most important part of the ship. I'll agree with that. How concerned are we about this bit on the inside? Like, do I need to wedge this and stuff, or can I just leave it? What do you guys think? No, don't need another red light. Okay. All right. Let's clean up the glass, because we put in those wedges earlier, and I never came back to finishing this bit. So let's do this. We're gonna switch these out with wedges, wherever we put wedges before. So this here, that's probably fine. We might alter that a little bit else at some other point. Okay, it's not as finished as I thought, apparently. Oh, okay. Like anybody who does art, though, will tell you that nothing is truly finished. Yeah, the rounded edges look a lot better from the inside, too. I think it'd be fine to leave it. Okay. Yeah, I'm with you guys. I think it looks pretty good. I think it looks pretty good. Okay, do we need any more, like, details in here? I think this looks fine, too. I don't think this needs more details either. This has enough going on that it's interesting. So what's next? Let's figure out the back wall for this bridge then. I think this looks great down here. I'm very pleased with how this came out. We gotta figure out something to do in this space, but we'll get to that. The stairs, I like the stairs. Gotta do a once over of everything, you know, make sure everything is as you like it. So. Yeah, I think it looks pretty good. I think it looks pretty good. This might be, could be, that maybe could be Gray Hull. Nah, it was better. Dark. Okay. Any other changes we want to make? I see none. I think it looks fantastic. I think we look good. We could maybe hide that, but I don't need to. It's nice to be able to access gravity, I guess, from the bottom too. All right, so let's figure out this door then. Doors are pretty straightforward, and I'm using the same style door across all the ships. So with the wedges, if we fly over like to this ship and look at it, so instead of just doing the regular round door, I took out two of the wedges, and I think it makes it look a little more interesting. Oh yeah, for sure. Loose command structure, small crew. Yeah, that's all about me. The fewer people in the crew, the less I have to share my treasures. The bigger shares we each get. So we wanna do it with as few people as we can. Okay, can I remove any of these? Okay, good, 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 good. Because I'm thinking we put the door here. So that'll be door.
No, it needs to be three. It is three. Okay, that's good. Like this. Like that. It's actually centered on, okay. I did not do that intentionally, but I think that works. Centered on the back of the bridge. Now, is it too close, though? Do I need to move it back one block? If I do, if I move it back one block, I run into problems because this is a ceiling as well. So I can't really change these blocks out. I don't like that. I've kind of pigeonholed myself. Quick note, dude, I've tried to copy stuff off of other ships I've built. They all suck. The ships I've taken stuff off of other ships and put stuff onto new ships, those ships are worse than the ones I copied from. Okay. Yeah, I'm kind of the same way. Like, it's hard. I can copy design elements, but if I copy exact pieces, it just doesn't quite work. I have been able to copy thrusters before, and the thrusters work okay. Like these three thrusters, they're exactly the same as this one, and these two are exactly the same as these two. So the thrusters, I was able to reuse like that. But yeah, you're right. Like, for the most part, you can't really reuse assets like that. Like some of the stuff you can, but it's tough. It's tough to get it all working. Okay, we might still be able to work with this because. If I do this, because that's going to be the other side of the door. I don't know what I'm going to put in the middle yet. How does that look from in here? Is that a big deal? It's not a big deal. It's not a big deal. We can leave that gray, so that's not a big deal at all. And then this can be gray. I don't know. These blocks can be whatever. So we can have a gray stripe. Yeah, that's fine. That'd be fine. I mean, you're good, man. You're not forced to do the door straight in the middle, though. No, I'm not. I'm not. But I want it in the middle. I actually accidentally did it in the middle, or it wasn't intentional. I don't want it straight off the stairs, so I don't want it here. If I put it on this side, then I'm even further pigeonholed by the teleporter room. So I think in the middle actually works for this ship. Now the hallway is probably going to come out and curve one way or the other. Because I'm going to do something similar to that ship where there's like a long hallway down one side and then the rooms kind of come off of it like this. It may come off of this side though, I'm not sure. But I think the hallway in the middle actually works for the ship. All right, let's throw a door in. And a display module. And this will be, oh gosh, I don't even know where this hallway is going to lead to. So let's put one on this side instead. And facing the other way, though, this way. And this will say bridge. And I think about there. Oh no, I did it wrong. What have I done? Oh yeah, it's gotta go at the D and edit. There we go. Okay, good. Bridge. So simple. Oh, you know what? These doors are much better. Let's do doors like that. Blast. Yeah, a step up into the door. That's a good idea. That's a great idea. And then we don't have to worry about the floors being weird. I'm with you. I'm with you. I like it. Okay. But, okay. Yeah, and then we can really put it wherever we want. It can go anywhere. I feel like we're at a pretty good stopping point here. It's about time for me to get some lunch anyway. So I'm thinking we're gonna call the stream here. But I'm digging this streaming thing. I think we'll keep working on this on live streams. If you guys follow me on Twitter, I'll announce when my streams are on Twitter. I don't really have a schedule, so I'm not sure. I can't say when the next stream is going to be just yet, but I definitely will let you know. But thank you guys for stopping by. I had a lot of fun working on this with you guys. I like doing the live streaming stuff. I think we'll definitely do this more often. But that's going to be it for me. I will see you guys. Hopefully we can get a StarMade video out soon, but I'll see you soon.